In this video, we will show how to build a small version of a brushless DC motor using easily available materials such as plastic jars, screws and bolts, magnets, and copper wire for windings. After building a simple version of a brushed DC motor, and after having deepened the working principle of brushless motors, we are now ready to build an educational version of it. The largest plastic jar will be the stator of our engine, while the smaller one will be the rotor. We make a hole in the center of the bottom of the larger jar, and we do the same thing on the cap. Let us mark 4 equidistant points around the surface of the jar, where we will create the 4 electromagnets of the stator. From an iron hanger, we get a rod of about 7 inches in length. This will represent the drive shaft of our engine. We make now the holes also in the smaller jar, in this way. So we have now created the structure of our brushless motor. On the smaller jar, we mark the points on which we will fix the magnets. We will fix a total number of 12 magnets, putting them side by side around the surface of the jar and making sure to alternate their polarities. So, for example, on this magnet, we will put the glue on the surface that is repelled by the nearby magnet, and so on. The rotor of our engine is now complete. We make sure that we have correctly alternated the polarities of each magnet. Now, let's take a plastic tube of about 0.16 inches in diameter, and we will cut a 0.24 inches section. We glue this section in correspondence of the hole on the jar representing the rotor. Now, we cut a section of about 2.4 inches from the plastic tube and we fix it on its cap, always in correspondence of the hole. This is to keep the rotor in position inside the stator. After having carefully marked the four sections of the jar, let's create the four holes around its surface. Now, we can insert the screws and bolts inside each hole. We coat the screws with shrinkable plastic tubes, and we stick them together by heating them with a lighter. The screws represent the supports on which to wrap the copper wire. In this way, we will create the coils of our motor on which the electric current will flow. Around each screw, we draw the direction of each copper winding, which in turn will determine the direction of the magnetic field that will be generated by the interaction of the coils with the magnets. Also, in this case, the direction of the windings must be alternated. To create the windings, we will need a double copper wire of 0.25 millimeters in diameter. We're going to wrap the double copper wire around each screw. The diameter of the screws must go from 11 millimeters to 15 millimeters. Eventually, the impedance of each individual winding will be around 12 ohms, so that the total for each exiting circuit shall be a maximum of 48 ohms. This is the result we need to achieve. As you can see, the ends of the copper wire are these two, plus a third one, that will act as a common point. As you can see from this scheme, which we will need to follow to create the connections of the copper wires. Now, we connect four cables to the four terminals of a Hall effect sensor. The Hall effect sensor is a device that is used to measure the magnitude of a magnetic field. Its output voltage is directly proportional to the magnetic field strength through it. So, the circuit AH266 driven by this sensor will alternately pass the current on the two windings whenever the sensor changes the magnetic flux to which it's subjected. Since windings create opposite poles when they're crossed by the current, there will be a continuous inversion of polarity in the electromagnets that will repel or attract the permanent magnets of the rotor, all in a synchronized way. That's because the magnets of the rotor will drive the Hall effect sensor. Now, we're connecting a power supply terminal to the positive red wire, and the other terminal to the negative white wire. Then, we fit it to the stator. After creating every single connection, we can assemble our engine. We apply a plastic propeller to the motor shaft. By increasing the current flow, our brushless motor starts working. As we expected, the circulating current is about 400 milliamps and has a voltage of about 10 volts. We built a 4-watt brushless motor. By adjusting the voltage, we see that the speed increases. That's because the Hall effect sensor is synchronized with the rotational motion of the magnets. The maximum voltage at which this device can operate is around 12 to 13 volts. This sensor cannot handle more than 500 milliamps, so be careful not to overdo it. Finally, if you found this video useful, let us know by leaving a comment and subscribing to our YouTube channel to stay tuned on the latest release of new videos. Thanks for watching.